wonderful. Okay. He was a good partner. He was a nitpicker. We were exact opposites. I was the slob and he was the nitpicker. And he tried vainly for all our 37 years together to change me, and it didn't work at all. And I was never able to change him. And I guess that's the essence of a happy marriage. I enjoyed his company. He had a good sense of humor, and he was always willing to listen to what I had to say and to respect it. That's a partnership, and it was a good one.
One thing that I noticed was what a good provider he was. I remember going to the Kodak place, where he was working at Kodak, and I was surprised he was getting like a candy bar for himself out of the machine. It just surprised me that he would get anything for himself.
Well, you know, with five kids, he saw to it that you were never hungry and you never lacked for a place to sleep comfortably. And he did the very best he could to make you happy.
He surely did share. A feeling like that, where even a candy bar, him taking it for himself, seemed out of character.
Yeah, he was a little bit of a martyr. I often told him I didn't mind his wearing a crown of thorns, but I wish he wouldn't pull it down around his ears.
Not ask for credit for it, right?
Yes, I know. Yes. But he was a good guy, and I had a lot of fun with him. I remember when we were courting, we didn't have any money, so we went for these long walks. We'd go 4 or 5 miles and just run around in the snow. And at all hours of the day or night, walking was our way of communicating, walking and talking together. It made a way of our getting to know one another really well. So as time went on, we kind of knew what we were going to say and do because we were so well acquainted.
Yeah.
I really feel sorry for a couple that never gets to really know one another. And I think that sometimes that's what's really wrong with marriages that go on the rocks.
I think it's important to realize there's a whole other person out there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And John never forgot that. If he tried, I would not let him.
I remember how supportive he was of you changing over to becoming a poet, you know, that he was so...
Religiously, he sent them off to magazines, and we got rejection slips enough to paper the bathroom. I was suggested it to him, but he never did that.
I remember him like ironing things with it, and I don't know, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah,
it was very, very, it was unusual to have somebody so supportive.
Well, let me tell you something. I don't know how many men would listen to their wives proposing to set off into the wild blue yonder with no definite places to go, and with all five kids and the dog and the cat, and simply transform themselves into a wanderer until we could find a place to be. And I'll never forget driving into town and finding a dog asleep in Main Street. And he knew and I knew that this was the best place to be.
Well, that's true, right? Today with the mule deer are the new dog, right?
Yeah, we certainly have enough livestock wandering around. I'm glad you didn't hear the coyotes. Every so often the coyotes get lively, and everybody locks up their pets because they have a nasty habit of chewing it on cats and dogs.
Yeah, I know that they do, and I did see a coyote, and it's a very formidable thing. It has the front legs higher than the back, and it's quite a formidable looking creature right across the street from your house.
Yeah,
that was pretty exciting. Well, also, I think that Dad, you know, what Diane always said about him was, how in the world could somebody who never built anything get a bunch of government pamphlets and build a wing?
He'd try anything. Try anything. You know that song that they sing about the ant that tried to transport the rubber tree plant? That was it. Here he goes, another rubber tree plant. He never really was defeated by the difficulty of a project. And I think that may be why he married me. It would have been difficult to find anybody else that would put up with me. But we did grow for 37 years, 5 kids and 7 grandchildren. It wasn't hard. We were together. Remember that song we used to sing? Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe ragged and funny, but we traveled along, singing this song, side by side.